Hello, everybody. Welcome back to American Truck Simulator once again. Before we get started today, I want you to go down to the description and check out Riding with Dave. He is a trucking YouTuber. We'll talk about his channel and stuff here in a minute, but I want you to go there. If you enjoy these videos, you're really going to enjoy his content. I've been watching a lot of it. I really respect a lot of the truck drivers out there that put themselves out there on YouTube, and he's definitely one of my favorites for sure. So with that said, it is early morning here in Grand Junction, Colorado. We have a pickup at Costco, and we're going to be going to Denver. So we're actually going to get to go down Highway 70 right through the mountain pass. Should be a good time. And I did get all of my mods reinstalled, a bunch of them. We'll go over all of it at the very end of the video. So if you want to see that, stick around for that. We have a CFI trailer and CFI truck paint here. This is the default T680. And as you can see here, it is a nice texture. And it is a 4 Series trailer too, because it's got a 4,000 number on it. So let's go ahead and get over to Costco. Parking brake comes in, and we are driving an automatic. These things have a automatic transmission. It's the Eaton Fuller Ultra Shift transmission, actually. And on top of that, you have, let's get our lights on. On top of that, you have the X15, the Cummins X15 engine. Now, there's no X15 engine really out there for American Truck Simulator, up to date at least. And the sounds we are running here is an ISX engine, so by Creech Bomb, which is a fantastic one as well. This is that confusing truck stop where we always go, is this the way out or the way in? It's both. Whoa, okay. Well, we just had a ghost truck happen there. That was interesting. We got a ton of mods in here, man. And I am running a reshade, finally, with HDR enabled. A lot of people said my videos were too dark, and I do agree with you there. So I've been looking at all sorts of options. I wanted to wait until we were all done with the showcasing of Colorado, because we couldn't use any mods. So Costco's up here on the left. So we are running the reshade presets, and it's amazing, absolutely amazing. I will have it linked in the description below if you want to check it out yourself. So yeah, we got the 400 horsepower engine in this thing. We are a company driver through and through. We've got the AI traffic mods back in there. We got Jazzy Cat. We've got all sorts of fun stuff there. We got my whole setup here. I always get asked how I look around freely. That is the Track IR version 5. It's a head tracker. And we're on a motion rig, by the way. You'll see my legs move back and forth once in a while. We are on a GT Track by Next Level Racing. And the Motion Platform V3 by Next Level Racing. Thrustmaster TSPC Racer. We got a Ferrari wheel, Thrustmaster wheel here on the back, and then a Rickmotech adapter there. Oh, they have a gate here they have to open for us. That's cool. And then the NRG Innovations 18-inch wheel. All right, they're opening it up for us. Sweet. So it looks like they want us in what dock? Over here on the left, perhaps? All right. Before we get going here, we're going to... Well, we're going to talk about Dave's channel and stuff and the reasons why I like it. Those of you that know me, I do tend to... Oh, man, this is going to be like almost a blind back, it looks like. All right, there's a Costco truck over there. We don't want to hit him. So if we get our trailer lined up here, we should be all right. Let's see what we got. Yep, right there. All right, so what I'm going to do, we're going to have to kind of... We might get a straight back in here if we go to the right and then... curl up next to that guy on the forklift. It might be okay. Let's see what we got here if we set this one up right. Let's see if we were good on that. Yeah, it wasn't too bad. Could have been better. There we go. We're pretty set up there. So now we can just go ahead and start backing her in. But yeah, the YouTube channel of Riding with Dave, he started out as a moto vlogger, actually. And, you know, I do some moto vlogging from time to time. And then he started getting into trucking and became a truck driver. Hold on, this is going to drive me nuts, this cord over here. All right, I got the cord situated. It was a pain in the butt. There we go. Now I can see my... Nope, it keeps falling out on me. No, it's good. Okay, cool. But he started out as a moto vlogger, and Then he got a job as a truck driver, and he started making a YouTube series on being a rookie at CFI and going through his life there. And it's very, very fascinating. It's awesome. He's a very humble and nice dude. And we resonate on a lot of things. He'll say something, I'll be like, you know what? We have got to be close to the same age, and we are. All right, let's see. Back it on up like that. All right, that they should be happy with this, actually. I think let us bump the dock, though. That's the real question here today. You gonna let us bump the dock? Close to it. There we go. Let's see if we can bump it. A bit more. There it is right there. Sweet. Go ahead and shut her down. And we're gonna go ahead and get loaded. Cargo's been loaded. Now it's about 8:35 a.m. We are in the dock here, and we are ready to go to Denver. Let's go ahead and fire the engine up so you can listen to Creech Bomb sounds. They're always really nice. Parking brake in. We don't have a little, thing we can put the, we can't use the ultra shift the way it is in real life. We have to use our shifter, but it's in a real automatic mode, so we should be good on that. Let's go ahead and put our secondary lights on here. There we go. And we're ready to get out of here. Man, this reshade looks absolutely beautiful with the SSAO. It looks so damn good. On this new PC, I have had no problems running this this sim. And it shows. All right, making a right out of here and then a left. And I think we're just taking 70 all the way to Denver today. That's what it looks like. So yeah, I really, really enjoy his stuff. And go over there, give him a warm welcome. He's not a tiny, tiny YouTuber either. He's got a pretty decent channel and just really entertaining. So if you want to know what I've been watching, I've been watching him. I love seeing somebody, humble and is a rookie at driving, and he has no problem showing his mistakes he makes. And, you know, even being a virtual trucker myself, it is nice to watch something like that and you learn from it, you know? All right, we're making a left up here, and we should get right on the highway. Wow, this looks absolutely beautiful. And we're running the fall, early winter mod as well. You can hear all the trucks around here. Nice Peterbilt there, some hay. Somebody, oh damn, he hit his Jake brake and just came to a complete stop there. All right, let's roll up our window. There we go, wonderful. Well, happy Sunday. I hope you guys have had a great weekend and you're ready for the week ahead. That's what it's all about, man. That is what it's all about. And I know I'm definitely ready for the week ahead. One week closer, man. I know you're probably getting tired of me talking about house stuff, but we are supposed to close on the house by the 25th. They think it could be as early as the 23rd. But who knows? Let's do some outside view action for you here on this turn so you can see the truck in all her glory. Tried to make it as close as I could to a CFI T680 because they went over to these things recently, and they are pretty slick looking rides, honestly, I must say. There we go. We got a decent trailer. We don't have a crappy trailer, as you can see. That's got a 4,000 number on it. All right, let's stick to the right-hand side here. Let's not be a crappy driver. Let's get in the left lane, and we are going to be getting on the highway up here, it looks like. Yep, east 70. That's what we want, left lane. So we're jumping right on 70 out of the gate. Turn that off. Don't need that on. All right, Grand Junction, Denver. That's what we want. Oh, it's one of those crazy ones where you have to cross over and then back around to get on the highway. It's kind of cool, though. I'm getting used to them. Man, I cannot get over how great this reshade looks, you know, with Jazzy Cat's mods and the real cars. That's too realistic right there. We're using CIP's wonderful AI mod, so we have some decent traffic again. All right, left turn here. That actually works really well because you don't have to worry about going through that intersection. You can just hop right on the highway. I like that a lot. I'm trying to get the trailer in the grass there too much. And we're finally on our way to Denver from Grand Junction. Weird not shifting gears, trust me. It is very strange. We might get some hiccups and skips and stuff. I'm still, you know, dialing in graphic settings. Man, this looks gorgeous. Where, man, you know, I wish I could have done things like this on my last PC, but we just had so many issues, it wasn't even worth it. Get our Jake brake on. Now, that's a question for you guys that drive maybe for CFI or drive one of these trucks. What is the what is the deal with the Jake brake? Do you use the Jake brake? I would imagine you do have even, you know, three-level Jake brakes, engine brakes, whatever you want to call them. I would imagine that would be the case, but I'm not 100% sure there. Yeah, I'm feeling it now. There's the Jake brake sound. You can turn that sucker down. We don't need that thing all the way up. We'll need it going through the mountains for sure. Yeah, the traffic seems very, very nice with the traffic density mod by CIP. He's always kicking butt with that. I've always ran it. We've got the Real Companies mod by Grimes. We got so many mods to talk about. if I see it, I'll bring it up if I'm reminded by it. Little bumps here and there. Man, look at that spillway there. That looks amazing. Now we're doing an external contract because we're doing that Colorado run. That is beautiful. We're doing that, so not buckled. No, I'm not, because people make fun of me if I put my seatbelt on in my rig. Just kidding. In real life, yes, you should. But for the sake of the sim, no, we don't. We're not buckled up. Oh, nice. We got a beautiful tunnel here. You know what we have to do for this. Roll the window down. And we're going to hit our Jake brake in here. Sounds so cool. It really does. It sounds amazing. And we've got that that sound pack fix mod as well, so we get the rushing of wind when you roll the windows down and all the sounds of the highway and trailer. It's good stuff, man. It's good stuff indeed. So yeah, we're just gonna take 70 all the way through. Oh, we're gonna be stuck behind this guy for a while, it looks like. I turn my engine brake off up the hill. We don't need that. Keep right, except to pass, yep. So we're kind of screwed right now. We need to stay right behind this guy. That works for me. Yeah, this autumn, early winter mod looks so beautiful here in Colorado. And I gotta say, hats off to the guys that are making mods, dude. They have been on it since the Colorado DLC dropped. And how about the big news that was dropped today? About they're bringing the new Cascadia to American Truck Sim as a default truck. I'm excited for that. I am indeed. The modded one out there isn't terrible, but I've was had issues with getting everything working perfect with it. Oh man, we are feeling that 400 horsepower now, aren't we? This is all she's got. Glenwood Springs and Aspen. This is freaking amazing, dude. Absolutely amazing. All right, we're getting around these guys. They're going so damn slow. We're not screwing around with that. We're in Glenwood Springs, and we have to just stay on this highway all the way through anyway. Unbuckled, seriously? I promise you, I'm in a sim. Oh, we got an idiot pulling out in front of us, hitting the brakes. Let me go up into the mountains, as you can see, so that's why I want to get around this slowpoke. Saw the gate there in case they had to shut the road down for winter. So it looks like all the deciduous trees are turning yellow and all that, and then you still have your coniferous trees that are staying green. Yeah, evergreens. Yeah. I'm glad we did that, because we would have been stuck behind that mess right there, and I did not want to do that. I see you, car. But I need to get over. Nope, you're gonna be one of those. Okay, cool. We'll just hang out in the left lane for now, but we're going through a mountain pass here. I'd rather be in the right lane. There we go. All right. trying to get all the speed I can because I know we're going to be going up in the hills here. All right, buddy. Hitting the brakes. Speed limit 50 through here. Yeah, this reshade, man, this just looks real. Like, this is the most realistic I've ever seen American Truck Simulator. I have got to say. Just absolutely amazing. And the name of the reshade is Red something. And I'll just link you to the SES forums if you want to check it out. And then just follow his instructions. I don't know why I said install twice there. Install. Hanging Lake. All right, we're doing all right here. We're going up the hill now, so we're going up through the mountains. And then when we go down, we're going to take it easy. And we're just enjoying this ride. This is beautiful. Yeah, going back to Dave's channel, man. Just, I know for a fact you guys will enjoy it. I do. Entertaining dude, too. There's a lot of different, YouTube truckers out there. And I think that's amazing because, you know, you're taking, you know, if you're monetizing your videos as a trucker, you're, you can do pretty darn good on YouTube. You know, if enough people want to watch you. Oh, we discovered a new viewpoint. Nice. If enough people want to watch you, man, it can be a nice, you know, secondary income. But it's kind of a catch-22 because... Oh, engine brake time. Because, you know, you're going to be using your job as your content. That changes things up, I can imagine. You can't really get away from the job that you're doing, but... It is a thing. And hats off to all you guys that drive the real deal. I don't sit here and drive an America Truck Simulator and, you know, think I'm a real trucker or anything like that. I get inspiration from other people that, you know, drive trucks to do it somewhat correctly and stuff. And there's that audio skip again. I had it really bad on a stream and I had to restart my PC. But man, it's this audio driver for my Go XLR. It is not very good, and the old one used to be good. I'm just enjoying this drive, man. This is gorgeous. Oh, there's a little pothole or whatever on the road. I added that. That's another mod I added. It's like a environmental mod that just randomly throws those at you. So it feels like you're somewhat on a road because... Like I talked about, you know, using the motion platform, it doesn't feel like you're on a road sometimes. Sometimes it's just a little too smooth. And it helps, you know, just kind of remind you you're on the road. Eagle River. Nice and green down there. That's cool. Yeah, still doing it. Poncho Springs Alamosa. I remember to remedy it. I'm going to turn the audio level down. On my end, maybe that'll prevent it from being stupid acting. I don't know. It's a pain in the butt, man, but every time you get a new PC and new setup, you're gonna have to you have a whole new world of problems. That's PC gaming in a nutshell. 55 around the corner here. Be careful. It's sharper than it looks. Now somebody's pulled over up here. Oh, we got some idiots being dumb. Oh, we got another CFI up there. Nice. Another CFI truck. Well, he's the one causing issues. Come on, CFI, get going, man. Oh, everybody's hitting the brakes now. And that really sucks because we were going up this hill. And now they're screwing us completely. And the fire truck's going up there saying, hey, I want to get on the highway. Here, I'll be nice. I'll be nice, guys. Here, go. Go, get on the highway. I'll be nice and let you in. There you go. Get going, buddy. Get going. There we go. Nice. So we're on an external contract, and with that said, you only can go 65. So we're not going to even be able to go over that anyway. Unless we're going downhill. But we want to be safe. We want to be safe. All right. Yep, this is what I was worried about. You know, we got really stopped there, and now we're going to be going up this hill. We're not super heavy, though. We got household appliances, you know, 28,000 pounds of those. Going to the airport in Denver, actually. Not bad. Yeah, we're only 28,000 pounds. That's not bad. Not bad at all. Oh, these audio skips, man. I'm sorry. It just sucks. Nothing I can do. Let's get those lashes on, dude. We're going slow up this hill. It's going to be a while to get through this pass, I have a feeling. But, you know, when you go up, you have to come back down. And that'll be fun. Oh man, it is skipping bad now. That's the problem, man. Everybody always wants, they always just tell you, you know, you should go, you know, update your drivers constantly. And it's like, dude, it just, when you have one that works, it's great. When you have one that's, you know, garbage, it's not. Oh man, we're gonna be stuck behind this dude all the way up this hill too. I had a feeling that was gonna be the case. When he passed us, we were in that traffic jam. It's like, we're gonna be stuck behind this guy. And dude, I have the pedal to the floor right now, although this guy's going super slow. I'm not getting in that hammer lane because I don't want to be that guy. We're lightly loaded, you know. Get braking traffic, maybe we'll be okay to get around this guy. I think we can do it here. Let's try it. I think we can do it. Because we're definitely faster than him by just a hair. We're going to do it. Sorry, buddy. You're just, you know, a little too slow for us here today. And we don't have anybody really behind us except for a couple trucks, so it works. Truck brake check, half a mile. We're gonna have to do the brake check. So not really even worth it anyway. Stage one fire ban. Don't want any forest fires there, Smokey. New viewpoint. This is the truck brake check. All right. Tunnel facilities closed to the public. All right, we're gonna make sure our brakes work and everything. We'll get back out there. I don't think we can do it. I don't think they would let you. I think we might be stuck if we don't do that. Sorry there, truck. He's gonna let me in. Nice, thank you. I'm just a dummy. I thought we were supposed to pull off there to do our brake check, but apparently not. Stop here on red, I see. Oh, you could pull in there and check them, okay. It's the Johnson Tunnel, 1979. Well, it's a sim. We don't have to check our brakes. We know they work. But I am going to do a video on that. I told you I will. So be looking out for that soon, where we're going to do the runaway truck ramps. All right. We can turn those flashes off. We're going to be getting through the speed now. Engine brake back on. So we have that if we need it. We're only supposed to be doing 50 here in this tunnel. We're doing 55. We don't want to speed too much. Roll my window down just a little bit here. Cruising high below. There we go. Slow down. I got an idiot bus trying to cause a crash here. Nope, it's another truck up there. Hey, it's Rocky Mountain Doubles. I'm getting over here. No, we're not. That truck's not going to slow down at all. That's the only issue, man, with the AI is the merges are so bad. I don't care about you, bus. I'm not letting you in. Sorry. Downhill grades, next 44 miles. How are your brakes? They're good. 5% and 6% grades, next 12 miles. Staying low here. We're entering the Arapahoe National Forest. Since we're going to be doing some jake braking going down the hill, we'll go ahead and get the open our windows just a little bit here. Sounds awesome. Good old Steamboat Springs, 1 mile. That's where we're at. We're just south of that. South of that spot. Oh, Captain Canada playing Microsoft Flight Simulator. Nice. Yep, there it is. There's that audio. And now we're slamming brakes the last second to get off the exit. That's cool. Thanks for keeping us on our toes there, bud. Appreciate it. Yeah, that's going to be number priority for me. Number one priority. I'm going to get the audio driver switched out because that's garbage. Should not be doing that. I've read online some other people have had issues with the GoXLR too doing that. Alright, here we go. Going down the grade now. I mean, everything else would have been perfect on this run today had we not had the audio screwed up on us. That's YouTube in a nutshell, though, man. If something can go wrong, it will. Runaway truck ramp, 2,000 feet. Oh, God. Quit with the cutting of audio. That's a big runaway truck ramp there, man. That's huge. That's awesome. Oh, come on, man. Just stick with it to the end, audio driver. Can you not do it? Roll our windows up. Maybe we're just asking too much. I don't get it, dude. That, or maybe it's getting hot. Our AC's out again. I'm so glad we're moving and getting our own place. We have to go this way towards Denver. I'm coming over here, buddy. Sorry. Should have my blinker on, but oops. It gets so hot in this room. I don't get that, man. If I was a landlord, I would never put people through something like that of having your AC go out and, you know, at least it's kind of starting to get cooler down here in Florida, but middle lanes. That's what we're gonna do. We gotta be getting close. I know we're going to the east side of Denver today, but we get to go through downtown, which would be cool. 55 through here, so let's slow down. There we go. That's a little bit more like it. One big truck's going right over us. There's Denver on the right there. That's cool. And we are delivering on the east side of Denver. All right, PC, just hold together for a few more miles, man. We're almost done. We're almost there. Please. That's all I'm asking of you. We can go ahead and hit the cruise control there, so we don't have to worry about that. We're fine on fuel. We weren't going to have any problems with that. We weren't going to problem. God, I can't speak. Can't speak sometimes. Road work ahead. Imagine that. Slow her down. What lane is ending? Shoulder on the right. Okay, we're good. Yep, Denver International Airport is what we want. 3/4 mile. Come on, game. Just stick together for me, audio driver. Just hang in there. We're almost done. I promise you. Then you can go back to being dumb again. Hey, we're in Aurora. How about some of you guys live in Aurora? And that's a pretty big area. Oh, man. Huge frame drop there. Whoa, quite a few of them. Slower on down. Maybe it's the heat in this office. Maybe stuff's getting overheated. That's possible. I mean, not really. It's a brand new PC and it's, you know, water cooled and all that. We're almost there. Just hang in there, old girl. You can do it. Promise you. I'm going to get me a screenshot and then I'm going to let this bus pass me first, but I'm going to get a screenshot and then we'll be closer to where we need to be. All right, we are back. Got me a little screenshot there as we were on that overpass. Looked pretty cool. And we got the Colorado flag over there. That's cool looking. All right, so where's our exit? I've never been to the Denver International Airport to drop, so I have no idea where we're supposed to go. We will find out soon, though, won't we? They're slowing her down. Oh, look at all this. This is cool looking. Car, shuttle parking. I guess we're taking the exit. Oh, it changes color, too, just like the real airport. Oh, it's amazing. Oh, there's the horse. I know they have it modeled in here, so we might be able to see it. This is our exit here. There's all the airplanes there. Where's the horsey? He's probably further up there or something. He's on the other side. We couldn't see him from there. That's always possible too. I don't know. All right, making a right turn here. Oh, this is a classic like air cargo run. Jackson Gap Road. Get on out there, make a left turn up here. Actually kind of just cheat and just stick right here and then make the left. Air cargo, general aviation, yep. That is what we want. You're going left. Okay, go ahead, buddy. This truck's going right. You're fine there, buddy. Come on, audio driver, just stick with me. We're almost done, I promise you. Good Lord, man. Gotta love Windows updates and driver updates that just ruin your day. That's not ruining my day. I'm having a good day. Got an old DC-10 out there, looks like the blue one, and the classic. There's that DC-6 again that we saw in Montrose. Oh, crap. Are we supposed to be in this? Nope. Next one. Sorry. A viewpoint here. Cool. Costco Wholesale. I bet that's where we're going. Nope, doesn't look like it. We're going to the next one. This one here. All right, this is it. All right, we got the guard shack up here. We'll talk to them. Maybe they'll let us in. Tell us where we need to go. Hey, how you doing? Yep, all right. Okay, they want us in the dock over here on the right. Let's do it. It is Costco. We are delivering to the Costco. It's just their air cargo division or whatever. All right. This should be a pretty straightforward back. These are cool docks, though, man. There's a guy looking at a trailer there. That's neat. Are you kidding me? Are we supposed to be over there? Are we at the wrong place? No, we're dropping over here on the left, it looks like. Right there. Okay. Oh, man. All right. Well, this is going to be interesting, isn't it? I have an idea. We'll roll our window down first. Make sure we don't hit this thing on the left. This gate. Yeah. I'll turn it this way so we don't hit the gate. Good there. I'm going to go up in here, and then we're going to do kind of a U-turn thing and get ourselves set up for that back. I think we might be all right there if we do that. We go to the right here, and then we're going to go to the left up here, and we should be decent for this. Let's try to make old Dave proud with our backing skills here. There we go. That's somewhat decent. Let's see what we got. Let's take it easy here on the back. Doesn't have to be crazy. All right. And we have a lot of room here we can play with, so we're okay as far as that goes. Audio, piss off. And we're still going to have to, you know, obviously do one more. Get on the right side there. We just don't want to hit that wall. All right. That's good. Let's get out and look. Yep, we just keep on going straight back, and we're going to be all right there. We're not going to hit anything. There's nothing there but a wall. So once we get it close to the back, we can couple up front, and we'll be good.
All right, just keep on back.
Keep going back. We can go a little harder if we'd like. So we get that thing going sideways. There we go, like that. There we go. Looking decent here. There you go. Now we can get straight. Got plenty of room with that line there. Stupid audio driver, dude. Wow. It's real bad. Oh, we're so close to being in there perfectly straight. A little forward here. There we go. And on back. Back and on up. Yeah, this audio is not going to last, dude, much longer. There we go. They're happy with it. There's no dock to bump. We're just going to be dropping here. So there you go, folks. That's going to do it for that one. Shut the engine off here. Let's unload the trailer. And we got an excellent 300 miles, 46 minutes, 52.2 gallons of fuel. World of Trucks contracts completed 42. Look at that. Not too bad. By the way, if you want to get all this money and level up and stuff so you don't have to worry about money when you're doing mod showcases and stuff, you can just, you know, look for a profile mod. There's plenty of them on ATS Mods LT and all sorts of stuff like that. All right, so let's go to our mod manager here, and I'll show you exactly what we have and the load order we have it in, so you can kind of screenshot if you want the same thing. So realistic mirror FOV, we want our environmentals up at the top. Realistic mirror FOV icons, no boundaries. So icons gets rid of those, you know, flashy icons, gives you the white lines on the ground. No boundaries gets rid of those X's. The U.S. asphalt patch and random events. That's how I get this, the random, like, you know, potholes and stuff like that. Early autumn version 1.6. You can find these things on the SCS forums and the Steam Workshop. I'll let you know if there's something outside of that. Realistic graphics mod, realistic rain, realistic truck physics mod by FRK N64. Real AI traffic F-Mod sounds. Engine sounds pack 3.3 by good old Creech Bomb. You got pneumatic effects for automated transmission. Tire sounds by Creech Bomb. That's the sound fixes pack I was talking about. That's on the workshop. GTM's new, this is the pre-release version for 139 of the flares and stuff for the emergency vehicles. Flare pack for USA trucks and trailers. This is John Root stuff, so that's payware. Real advertisements, I use real companies and trailers pack 2.1. Real traffic density and ratio for ATS. And you can just Google these, man. You can just Google these and you'll be able to find them on either the Steam Workshop or where I get them. Municipal police traffic pack, AI traffic pack by Jazzy Cat, painted truck traffic by Jazzy Cat. I can't speak today, man. I'm just going to show you these. Real tires. So you have trailers edition and real tires. Smarties wheel pack. USA truck wheels and wheels for USA trailers. That's both John Ruta stuff. SISL's mega pack. I got a Swift master pack for something coming up. We got CFI trailer skin. That's what I'm using there. Got the Great Dane trailer skins for, and then all these different trailers here, as you can see, plenty of those. And this is all stuff for the Ruta 389, the Ford Aramax we used, and the Peterbilt 389. So all our trucks at the bottom. That is all of the mods I am using. You can, you know, feel free to, you know, pause the video and whatnot. But that's going to do it for this episode of America Truck Simulator. Go check out Riding with Dave and let me know what you think of his channel. I'm sure you guys are going to love it. And that'll do it. I'll see you next time. Take care.
Hello, everybody. It's Jeff. Just want to let you guys know that merch is available if you check out the link in the description below. And there should be some images you can click on below the video as well. Thank you guys so much for all the love and support. I do appreciate it.